Welcome to the Hudson Valley Community College Eyes on the Sky series, an update about current astronomy, space science, and sky events. I'm astronomer Richard Monda, and this is the Eyes on the Sky September 2023 episode. We start the fall semester with a waxing gibbous moon in the evening sky. It's positioned in the southeast on the western side of Capricornus, whose central stars form a big, yet somewhat faint, stellar smile. On August 29th, the moon is located on the eastern side of Capricornus, where the lunar sphere is still waxing toward full. On the 30th, we have the full moon among the dim stars of Aquarius, the water carrier. This full moon is also a supermoon, when the moon is within 10% of its closest approach to the Earth. Technically, it is a perigean full moon, because the moon is near perigee, its nearest point in its orbital path around the Earth. Not only is this full moon a supermoon, but it is also the second full moon in a single month, what is commonly called a blue moon. The August 30th full super blue moon helps us locate Saturn. One of Saturn's moons, called Enceladus, was imaged by the Cassini spacecraft. Cassini discovered and flew through active ice geysers released from this moon's south polar region. Below the surface of Enceladus, hydrothermal vents under a suspected ocean heat the water, while cryovolcanoes on the surface eject numerous water-rich plumes into space. Looking eastward around midnight September 4th, we see a bright star below the faint stars of Aries, to the upper right of the Pleiades star cluster, and above the brighter stars of Taurus. That star is Jupiter. A mission under development to study one of Jupiter's large moons is called the Europa Clipper. It would arrive at Jupiter in April 2030 and investigate Europa, a Jovian moon thought to possess an underground ocean. The spacecraft would make several flybys of this moon while in orbit around the giant planet. Currently planned for launch in October 2024, the main body of the Europa Clipper has already been completed. On September 4th, the 77% lit moon appears above and to the right of Jupiter. Now past full, the moon phase is waning gibbous. By midnight, September 5th, the moon has moved in its eastward orbit so that it now appears as a thinning gibbous, 68% illuminated. By September 6th, the diminishing gibbous is below the Pleiades, above the horns of Taurus, and above Aldebaran, the brightest star of the Bull. Looking east as dawn breaks on September 10th, we see the stars of the Crab and the Lion. These constellations are not only competing with a brightening sky, but above these star pictures is a waning lunar crescent, 4 days past last quarter and 17% lighted. On September 11th, the thinning crescent is positioned on the eastern side of Cancer. The moon continues to wane, now 12% of its surface facing the Earth is lit up. That morning, the moon is across from the Beehive star cluster, also known as M44. This loose cluster of stars is called an open cluster and is 600 light years away, meaning that its light takes 600 years to reach us. To the lower right of this cluster is Venus. Always radiant in its appearance, this planet will be the target of two future space missions. The Da Vinci mission, anticipated for liftoff in 2029, will release a probe to examine the Venusian atmosphere, while the Veritas spacecraft will orbit Venus and map its surface. By the morning of September 12th, the moon is among the stars that form the Lion's Mane, where it is 6% illuminated and on its way toward new. On the 13th, an ultra-thin waning crescent, a day before new, appears near the horizon, near the star Regulus, and near Mercury, all very low in the eastern dawn sky. Binoculars will help locate these celestial wonders. 3 days and 30 minutes later, these sky objects are higher in the brightening dawn, but the moon has moved on, now past new and creeping into the evening sky. Earth arrives at the autumnal equinox and fall begins on September 23rd at 2:50 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time. The next day, the Osiris-Rex spacecraft that gathered surface samples from an asteroid called Bennu will complete its mission by dropping its payload of surface material to the Earth. For details on this asteroid sample return mission, please see our Eyes on the Sky special edition episode, Rendezvous with an Asteroid. Looking east-southeast on September 26th, we find a waxing gibbous moon hovering low in the evening sky. This lunar orb, shining at 92%, drifts below Saturn and above the lone bright star among the autumn constellations, the star Fomalhaut. Images of Fomalhaut by the James Webb Space Telescope show a planet-forming disk around this young star. An hour after sunset on September 27th, the 97% waxing gibbous is closer to the east-southeast. The next evening, the moon comes into view near the horizon and is the day before full. Then at 5:57 p.m. on September 29th, the moon reaches its full phase. This is the harvest moon, the moon occurring closest to the fall equinox. Finally, a mention about a special sky event this October. On October 14th, there will be an annular or ring-type eclipse of the sun. In upstate New York, only 20% of the sun will be covered. But from Oregon to Texas, the moon, appearing a little smaller than the sun, will seem to fit within the solar disk, leaving a ring of fire surrounding the moon. Safe solar eclipse glasses will be needed for viewing this special partial eclipse. Thanks for watching our September 2023 Eyes on the Sky episode. I'm astronomer Richard Monda, informing you that starting in October, there will again be weekly sky updates for the fall semester in our College Campus Chronicle. And as always, keep your eyes on the sky.